All right. Wow, I'm terrible. Welcome to Mediaholics MovieCom. I'm Marissa, joining with Blaster. Say hello.
Hello!
Hi. We're watching Pokemon Jirachi Wishmaker. This is day two, a part of our Sun Moon launch week.
Indeed. Yeah, and because, if I recall correctly, Jirachi Wishmaker doesn't use the intro to the anime, mm-hmm. if I may. I came from Pallet Town with a brand new world to see. Yeah. Don't know what's ahead, but it won't get the best of me.
Yeah, it doesn't
There's
use
There's so
that.
Much to learn and battles to be won. I might as well just stop now.
There you go.
To be fair, I sung along with it for Spell of the Unknown. It's a good song.
Yeah, I think the best openings were probably... I mean, I do like Spell of the Unknown, but I really like the first movie is the best, honestly.
It is, though. Every time I watch it, I can't help but remember one thing. There's an animation error in it.
Oh.
Yeah, you remember the shot where it pans up to Machamp flexing its muscles,
yeah.
and then it suddenly cuts back down to... Yeah.
Yeah, and it keeps repeating for some reason. I think that was English only, and didn't do that in the Japanese one.
I wonder why it did for English only.
I think it's to sync up with the music, because I think the song was too long for it, so they had to do it. Or maybe it was just, like, choice of editing. It's like, hey, kids like editing, so I don't think that was it, though.
More likely, kids will never notice this.
Yeah. So, are we going to start this?
Yep. As per usual with these on the Invisible Zero, we start the movie. So, care to do the honors as this is your pick?
Yep. And those of you who want to sync up proper, we're doing this right before the Miramax logo.
Indeed.
All right. Ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1. Got it. Alright, so... How long ago did you watch this movie?
I have not watched this in years.
I remember I had this movie... I bought this movie on DVD. And I had a DVD player. And, I would always re-watch this movie for some reason.
For some reason, this is one of the ones I don't really go back to.
Yeah.
And also, the Hoenn movies were the ones where most of them I watched via torrents originally.
Mm-hmm.
With the exception being the next movie we're going to be doing, Lucario and the Mystery of Mew.
Oh, hey, call back to Entei.
Indeed.
And Lugia and Celebi. Oh, yeah. One of my favorite movies I'm surprised we're not doing, surprised I didn't pick, was probably 2000.
It was a good movie.
Yeah.
So, we can do it another time.
Yeah, true. I chose this
movie. Hi, Kyogre, who will never appear until Temple of the Sea in a movie.
It's the future. But was that a repeat ball and a luxury ball?
Yep. Oh, Brandon! Oh, yeah, I forgot you are a thing. And I think that's an aroma... No, that's not an aroma lady, that's... I forget who Brandon's versing.
Rich girl, I think. Rich girl.
Maybe.
I mean, I remember third gen.
Yeah.
And this is what this movie is based on. Groudon, for some reason. This is
Yes, the movie called Jirachi Wishmaker is based on Groudon.
This is probably the only movie with Team Magma in it.
Yep.
This is the only movie with Team Magma.
Well, at least they go further than Team Aqua did. Team Aqua never appears in the movies.
Yeah.
We get their totally not knockoff versions of whoever they are in Temple of the Sea.
You always get these, like, weird Pokemon poachers and all that as your enemies, but this is just straight up Team Magma.
Yep.
Ooh, mysterious.
Spooky.
Okay, that's impossible. When did that happen? How did Pikachu do that?
It's using Volt Tackle.
Did he learn Volt Tackle? Oh wait, Volt Tackle was Gen 3, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was introduced in Gen 3.
Right.
Then why did he lose it for Electro Ball?
I don't know. Because recoil damage.
It's just... Let's replace the strongest electric move in the game for Electro Ball.
At least it looks cool. At least it still kind of looks cool.
Yeah.
I always love
the
weird
opening. Thing as well is that he still knows Quick Attack.
Mm-hmm.
You got rid of Volt Tackle and not Quick Attack?
And now he's going to get a Z move.
Yep.
I think Jirachi Wishmaker is the best logo.
Yeah, I do as well.
Yeah.
And at least on the plus side, with this movie, we can have a lot more reasonable excuses for why the Pokemon can do these sorts of things, rather than, in the case of Spell the Unknown, the joke me and Marcus had going through it is, why can you do this? Because, bitch, I'm Entei. Oh, right. This is when Mei
wasn't motherly?
Not motherly, but she was a bit more,
angry.
Annoying.
Yeah. I kind of like how they make the Slowpoke and Slowbro joke. I hate when things in Pokemon, like Team Rocket goes, hey, look, a rat came in. I'm like, what is a rat? Dear Pokemon, what is a rat?
Maybe they just couldn't say Rattata?
Or they're like, hey, are you chicken? I'm like, dear Pokemon, what is a chicken?
Yeah. Brock, did you take a left instead of a right?
I told you
to go right at the last tree.
I was going to say this is probably one of the movies with without a fake city, but then I realized, oh yeah, they do have a fake location in this too.
Yep, they always do. Like Greenville from Spell of the Unknown. No joke, that's the name of the town.
That's just stupid. But at least it didn't focus on the town. It focused on more of the weird stuff that happened.
True. And look at all those vehicles coming in.
Mysterious and spooky. I'm getting a Mystery Dungeon vibe from this music.
I am too, actually.
Probably the strings.
Probably.
So instead of the intro song like they do with all the movies, they instead have this really overly long scene of setting up a carnival.
Yep. Though at least on the plus side, it's not quite as bad as a lot of the Best Wishes ones, where they still use all the songs, but two of the three movies were just Pokemon being cute.
Yeah. What were the Best Wishes movies that you were referring to?
Victini and either Reshiram or Zekrom, depending on which version you choose.
Yeah, that was just stupid.
Keldeo and the Swords of Justice.
To be fair...
Kyurem and the Swords of Justice, sorry. And then Genesect and the Legend Awakened.
Hello, Wilmer. I never saw Genesect, or Genesect, or whatever you call him. I think the only good part of Keldeo was the first bit, without Ash and the gang.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah. Oh, hey, it's... well, I won't say it. Not the villain.
Behold! Magic!
Now, is it really magic, or is it really just illusion?
It's really Jigglypuff.
I love that sound they always reuse, the bouncy sound.
Yep.
Even when they set up...
The human version of Oricorio!
Oh, true. Of course Brock would have that reaction.
Of course, it's Brock.
I love it how... they're setting up, and even when nobody is looking and when no one's supposed to be there, they're all flashy about it.
Yep. Well, little do we know is that this is preparing for Disneyland, where there are no just standard employees. They're all cast members. They're all performers at all times. Admittedly, this is still a great way to set up a tent.
Yeah.
Speaking from someone who has set up tents before, and it's nowhere near that easy.
They just make a pineapple.
Yep.
I'm still confused about, like, how that tent is set up. Or even what the point of this is. I think it's all just kind of CG testing at this point.
I think so.
I mean, it's still nice to look at.
Yeah. Though, why do they have to set up their own track every time they want to set up a carnival? Why not just connect it to an already existing train line?
I see Wailord. And I think it's because...
Hashtag triggered.
I think it's because that train is actually small.
Yeah.
I like all like... Oh god, Brock. Good.
Womp womp.
I love how everything is based on... All the rides are based on Pokemon.
Yep.
Clown sightings.
Oh no!
Did you get clown sightings where you are, or is it only where I am?
I think it's only in America, because if there have been clown sightings in Australia, I don't know of them. And I certainly haven't seen any.
I haven't seen any either. I only saw them online.
Yeah.
Ooh, what's
in Behold, that? More magic!
Swablu!
Look at all the Swablu!
It just appeared out of thin air.
Yeah.
I love the concept of magicians.
Me too.
And the Pokemon he has are just actually really cool. Like Kirlia. Not Gardevoir. And Mightyena, yep, for some reason.
Oh, because why not? It's a Mightyena.
My question is, why not? Why not?
No, that's just too easy.
True. Oh, I think the Pikachu short for this was actually Camp Pikachu, if I'm not mistaken. And why not was in that?
Oh.
Now that's just Pokemon abuse. Come on.
Yeah. Oh no, it turns into a human Oricorio.
Yeah. And then why'd they show that off is my question.
Behold the special rock.
It's an amethyst.
Oh, the crystal gems are in this movie?
Oh my god, sure.
These are gonna be too easy.
Why is Rosh? I didn't mess up Brack, Ash and Brock. Why is Brock so bad in this movie?
I don't know. Though, to be fair, in the Advanced Generation, I think the only good character was Ash, ironically.
Mm-hmm. Max is pretty good in this. Now, Mightyena just looks dapper.
Yeah.
Now, why is Max the only one hearing this?
Because he needs to be important.
True. Now, why do you hear...
And back in the Advanced Generation, all he was in the Advanced Generation was...
A Pokédex?
I'm the smartass.
He was just a Pokédex, honestly.
Yeah.
Oh, I love the Pokédex in Gen 3. It's just Max. But you want to hear something weird about this?
Sorry?
You want to hear something really weird.
Sure.
I was looking up Pokemon shipping because I'm weird, and for some reason
coming from the Amor shipper.
That's totally not why I was looking up shipping, but
of course not.
But for some reason, worst ship, unpopular ship. I don't care about the ship, but Ash and Iris shipping is called Nagai shipping and not Wish shipping. The name Wish shipping was actually a joke ship given to Max and Jirachi. I don't get it either. But my favorite...
To be fair, at least on the plus side with Max and Jirachi, there's not as much canon to it as Ash and Latias in the last movie.
Yeah. I mean, my favorite...
Bitter May and Brock are bitter.
Mm-hmm. My favorite joke ship is probably Ash and Pikachu.
Now that's just wrong.
That's why it's a joke ship to me.
Okay. True.
I'm not sure if it's here.
Groping hands. Beware the groping hands.
But he says a move wrong for Dusclops.
Yep.
Wait, Dusclops don't hyper beam?
I think so.
Oh, this is a great quote. That's just a great quote from Meow.
Yeah. We are going to die.
Guess what? We're going to die. Bye. No, why you have to do it so late? You could have done it any time.
Now, where's the fun in that?
True.
Behold, flowers! We got them straight from Alola, along with this Oricorio.
Apparently, Alola...
We did?
The Great. How can Max get that title?
Oh,
right, because he actually said it.
Yeah. Also, a slight issue with calling them bouquets of flowers. There was only 3 flowers in each one.
Maybe there's more that you're not seeing. Bye, Pikachu.
Oh, yeah, Team Rocket actually do something in one of these movies for once.
Yeah, but it's just their usual shtick of catching Pikachu and failing.
To be fair, this was back in Hoenn, where it was a little bit more manageable that they were doing it.
Yeah.
Not in Kalos, where it's just, you've been doing this for almost 20 years, stop. Oh yeah, I think they're riding a whaler balloon.
Mm-hmm. This is just everything that they do in the show.
Yeah. Oh no, it's just a normal Zeppelin. But again, like, at least they do something, because in most of the movies they're just, oh, we're here for some reason.
True. I mean, didn't they do something in Spell of the Unknown, or am I mistaken?
Yep.
Did they do something?
In Spell of the Unknown, they closed the movie.
Oh. And that's the, That's the move that they got wrong. It's supposed to be Will-O-Wisp, but I don't know where Capitata came from.
Yeah, they love to say their own names every now and then.
No.
Like, I think Ash at one point... Well, I think Ash's Pikachu at one point knew Thunder Shock, Thunderbolt, and Thunder.
Well, at least those are actual names of moves.
True.
Capitata is not anything. I think it's just a Japanese name.
Yeah, it's probably just localization error.
Yeah.
Now get out of the movie!
Huh. They never say that in the movies, do they?
Nope, because they never need to. You'd say that now, Brock, but chances are they're going to come back into this movie where they will close the movie.
Yeah.
And it'll be a cone call. Oh, ferret roller coaster!
I'm going to ride that.
Yep.
I thought Jirachi was like your trump card or something. Why are you talking about it now?
I don't know. The Cocoon of Destruction?
No, Yveltal's not going to be a thing until a couple years.
Yeah.
Well, like, 3 generations.
I also think Yveltal's cocoon is a bit bigger.
Yeah.
Find itself a friend.
You only see this cocoon in the anime, never in the games.
Yep, but at least on the plus side, it could be worse.
Mm-hmm.
It could be like the GS Ball, which never appeared in the games outside Japan, appeared in the anime for 2 seasons and went nowhere, and appeared in the manga and was actually used for what it was supposed to do, catch Celebi.
I thought it contained Celebi, not to catch it.
Catch, contain,
okay.
Same thing, it's a Pokeball.
I saw a post... Hi, Jirachi. I saw a post...
Max, you're crazy. That's not a Jirachi, that's a rock.
It's a stone, Luigi. You didn't make it.
YouTube. Is it a chunk of the Waluigi moon?
It's a YouTube poop joke.
Yeah.
But I saw a post that said, if we were able... Hi, Waylord.
Waylord balloon.
Stop. It was a post that said, if we were able to deal with these anime, we are able to deal with, Sun and Moon anime is going to be. And the animes were Johto Journeys and Best Wishes.
Yep.
And I'm like, what was wrong with Johto Journeys? I scroll down and it's like one route to 20 episodes.
Yeah.
Which route was that?
May, you're being scammed.
Wait, what? Oh.
May, you're being scammed. Pikachu fireworks. Psyduck. Trico.
I always wonder how you do that. I never saw fireworks in the shape of anything.
It's possible to do it. It's just very hard to.
Zotad.
Torchic.
Beautifly is beautiful. Mudkip. That's Pokemon. That too. One time...
So I heard you like Mudkips, eh?
One time, I actually met the voice of, I think it was, like, Misty and all that. Jesse. Misty and Jesse. And she also did Mudkip. I'm like, oh, you do Mudkip? Remember, you know that Mudkip meme? She actually did the meme, and I just responded, yeah, I feel like I'm back in 2007.
Yeah.
Good, now I don't have to see Wailord anymore.
For now.
It was cloudy, but now it's conveniently clearing up.
Indeed.
I want to say
because it's plot.
Or Rayquaza, or Jirachi, or whoever's controlling the weather right now.
Yep.
And on a stormy night, do you ever wonder what's up there, or what's causing the storm? Either Kyogre, or Zapdos or something?
Well, at the moment I think it's Kyogre, because, well, out October and so far, we've had lots of really bad raining seasons.
Mm-hmm.
Well, really bad rainfall.
Yeah.
So, every time it's been happening, I was like, can someone please take the blue orb away from Primal Kyogre? It cannot be this hard to find a Pokemon controlling the rain.
Primal Kyogre can fly somehow. Can someone explain that?
Because, bitch, I'm Kyogre?
Sure.
Hey, Mantine can fly.
Aw, Max is sleepy.
Gold uses a Mantine and about 30 Remoraid to fly.
30 Remoraid? Well, I mean, yeah. At least Mantine is a part flying.
True.
Also, this song is also the credit song, and it is amazing.
That it is.
I.
There were, was this a song that appeared in the anime beforehand, or was this just
I think it needs
a song
just for this movie?
Yeah.
You can hear the full song in the credits, which is actually a mix of an English singer and a Japanese singer.
Indeed.
It's called Make a Wish, but I forgot the name of the people that sung it.
I didn't even know it had a name before now, so I don't know either.
I totally didn't listen to this song on repeat. What are you talking about?
At least it could be worse. I had to listen to the entire High School Musical 2 soundtrack for 3 years in a row.
Well, I mean...
Every night.
Well, I said it's not a bad song. I actually like listening to it.
Yeah. sure. Now they can all hear it.
Oh, yeah. It's telepathy. This is the movie where it starred the whole tiny Pokemon speaks through telepathy... No. The telepathy thing started with Mewtwo. This is all the... Starting with the tiny Pokemon that need love. Tiny legendaries that need love kind of thing.
Yep.
Or was that...
Which Hoenn does twice.
No, wait. Or Celebi started that, really. I heard this...
Yeah, Celebi... Thankfully, Celebi didn't have telepathy, but somehow Slowking did.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, no. Slowking didn't have telepathy. It just talked.
Yeah, Slowking just talked. I'm not sure if a normal Pokemon with telepathy, except for
Lugia had telepathy. That's what I'm getting confused
yeah.
with.
Yeah. Lugia didn't have telepathy, didn't reveal his telepathy until the ending of the movie.
True.
Lucario had telepathy for some reason.
But he's not even a psychic type.
He's a fighting steel. I don't get it either. Oh, hey, it's Sleepy Jirachi.
So, should we be taking it to Wish Cave? Or did we just recruit it from Wish Cave?
I think they probably got it from Wish Cave.
They probably did. That's not her name. Her name is Oricorio.
By Oricorio Bailey. Now I'm gonna... When I find that fire-type Oricorio, I'm gonna call her Diane.
I am too now.
Good. Wait, they didn't know Jirachi was in there before? I mean, they thought Jirachi was in there, but they weren't sure of it.
Yeah.
They just kind of used on the hatch Jirachi.
I'm totally not the bad guy. I totally didn't teach Lysander how to hide his villainy. What are you talking about?
Now, this is kind of against the title of this entire movie, but guess what? Jirachi can't actually make wishes.
Actually, he can, because he's about to.
No, they're going to explain it later.
Oh, yeah.
He could only teleport things. He doesn't actually make wishes. Nor can he actually learn teleport in the game.
Well, to be fair, Pikachu can't learn Surf, and yet... Yellow and all that.
Well, Pikachu can learn Surf through special means. I mean, in-game, you never found a Jirachi that can learn teleport. Max, what have you done? Also, chips aren't a type of candy. What are you doing, Jirachi? Happy Halloween!
Be careful what you wish for!
Happy Halloween! Crackers? What kind of candy are you getting? These aren't candy, this is just junk food.
I feel so sorry for the shop owner, who's just, where's all my stock going?
Jirachi, this is horrible. What have you done?
Jirachi, stop! Yeah, and this is what happens when you have a Pokemon that can grant wishes. Everyone turns to monsters.
But he can't actually grant wishes.
Exactly. But they don't know it yet.
Now, if you had a...
How much did he have in that truck?
Okay, Jirachi, I wish for lots and lots of amiibo. Come on, Jirachi, I know you can do it. Just as I said.
Yep.
May you have to pay for that. My cabbages!
I feel so sorry for that guy. Oh, yeah!
Except it's candy, not cabbages.
Yeah.
I have to say, Max, you have the best Halloween ever.
Yep.
This is the best. Bye!
Later, May!
Get rid of...
Sapphire's better anyway.
Oh, that was so good. I think this is one of the funniest movies.
Yeah. Sapphire's better.
True. Me right now.
Well, to be fair, what's the time for you right now and...
Like, 9, but I, like, took a 3-hour nap. And naps don't really do good for me.
Yeah, fair enough.
Why are they so happy
about
that?
This is why you're supposed to have a psychic type on you. That's actually stays awake.
Or you could be, like, an Ash and Kalos and have 3 flying types.
Yeah. Oh, wait, no, even better, yeah, because they do have a psychic Pokemon with them. You there, totally not the bad guy. Use your have your killer use confusion and lift all this stuff up for us.
True. Aw. I don't think he actually...
Jirachi, you didn't even hit anything.
You heard the contact, and there was no contact.
What did you hit?
Nothing. Hey, it's the title of the movie. You did it. You said it. Clown sightings!
Yep. No, God, not more of them. Is that why you picked this movie, for clown sightings?
That, it's the end of Halloween, and it has to do with nighttime, so, you know, for Moon. So, that's why I picked this movie.
Fair enough. Yeah, and that means that, because how much you want to bet Max forgets that he has to say goodbye to Jirachi by the end of the movie?
Yeah, Jirachi, you know how dangerous that is?
It's not dangerous for him. He can fly.
Now, if you were in one of these teacups rides, which Pokemon would you ride in?
I didn't actually get a good look at all of them.
There was
what were the
others? There was Skiploom, a Jumpluff, Aeron, stuff like that.
I'd probably go Jumpluff.
Me too. either jumps off or not.
What are you doing back in the movie? Get out! You're not needed.
They're just spectators at this point. I forgot how good Jessie's voice actress was in this.
Yeah, she all the voice cast got hit hard when it moved from post-4K. Oh, and hi, Waylord.
And to be fair, I do like how they're disguising with the balloons.
Yep. It's a nice bit of attention to detail.
Yeah. I like the whole concept of the whole...
Absol!
Hello, Absol.
Wait, does that mean he Mount Freezes near here?
Absol always appears before something bad happens. And if you see on the routes, besides Route 13, Absol appeared right by Sphere Pillar, where, you know, all yep. that stuff went down with, what was it? You know,
Yep.
the legendaries. Palkia Dialga. Also, May is dead now.
Yep. Ah, May. Still, Sapphire's better.
Yeah. I love how Jirachi is so childish.
Yep. And at least on the plus side, Jirachi's childish, whereas Manaphy was a baby.
Yeah. And comparing Jirachi... Aw. That's so cute! I wanted Jirachi!
I wish my Jirachi plush was a lot closer to where I actually am.
Yeah.
And ribbon the balloon.
Jirachi's probably one of my favorite design Pokemon. Also, hi!
I was told to go to Mount Freeze. Can you point me in the direction of Mount Freeze, please?
It's a really cool place with Articuno.
I thought that was the Frosty Forest.
Mount Freeze is by the Frosty Forest. Oh, no, wait. I'm thinking of another game. Whoops.
No, you're right. Because you go Frosty Forest to... It's a half dungeon near the end where you fight Articuno. Yeah. And then you go to Mount Freeze.
Yeah. But that's where you find Absol. My question is, why did you find Absol? Why was he there?
Because it needed to lead you to Mount Freeze to find Ninetales.
What came first, this movie or Red Blue Rescue?
This movie did, because this is for the original Pokemon Advanced.
Right.
Whereas Red Blue Rescue Team came out
and
last year of the Game Boy Advance's life.
And what happens with this Absol in further in the movie, I think Red Blue Rescue Team was actually referencing this.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Bye. I'm just gonna do that whenever he teleports things.
Oh, I feel sorry for Torchic.
Aw. They're fine, don't worry.
Ow.
They're fine. Yes.
It's gone sick and tired of the clown hunt of the clown sightings.
Clown lives matter, you know.
Yeah.
Of course, conveniently, same size of the cage and same trap door. Why do you have that?
Because plot.
Would that work on a dark type? I don't think that would work on a dark type.
I don't think so. Oh no, well, to be fair, hypnosis is just putting it to sleep, so it would still work.
I know, but psychic type moves aren't supposed to be able to hit dark types.
No, I'm not sure, honestly, off the top of my head, how Gen 3 mechanics work for it.
I mean, it's a status move. Somebody tell us. Somebody do us. Use hypnosis on a dark type.
In Generation 3.
Yeah, in Gen 3.
To get the best standings right.
I'll do it later. I have Emerald right here.
Yeah.
Can't do it right now. I'm not going to boot up my Game Boy in the middle of a movie.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, we're not missing much at the moment, so...
Yeah. What do you think May's wish was?
I don't know.
I wish Ash would never get an official ship. No, May? No, you don't. Probably something to do with Pokemon contest.
No, no. Wait, I've got a better idea for it.
What?
Her wish would be for a better shipping partner than Misty. And then Serena came to be.
Thank you. Anti-amore shippers, you're gonna hate this.
Yeah.
I don't care, though. Okay, this is just cruel, what happens to Jirachi.
Yep.
And Jirachi is confirmed male.
No, you don't know what you're doing. You're the evil villain. You don't know what you're doing.
No, but he's so determined. Look at him.
True.
Jirachi was
at least he's so flamboyant about it.
Jirachi was asleep through all of that.
Yep.
Now this is cool. He was actually part of Team Magma. Nothing in his design.
If you were kicked out of Team Magma, you have a problem.
Nothing about his design screams Magma to me.
Nope.
Well, I guess that's where the twist comes from. But it is right now 30 minutes into the movie.
Yep.
And we just found out that he's part of Magma and all this stuff is happening.
Little does he know, he grabbed a piece of the blue orb and not the red orb, so he's about to make a Kyogre.
No, I don't know what... He said it was like a fossilized part of Groudon.
Yeah.
If anything, I think just something's wrong with his machine, not the part.
Yep.
He couldn't have tested...
Well, that's what it actually is. I just wanted to say it as a joke.
What?
That it was a part of the blue orb, so it was about to create a Kyogre.
True. I'm surprised he didn't test this before.
You'd think he would, but then he wouldn't be learning from evil villain syndrome.
Yeah, true. It's hot, man.
Yeah, you got kicked out of Team Magma.
Is that really a hard thing to do?
Apparently.
If he was a part of Team Magma, why didn't he...
Behold, third degree burns.
If he was a part of Team Magma, why didn't he wear the, I don't know, a thing?
Scientist.
Oh, true.
I just feel sorry for him because his parents called him Butler.
Is that his real name? Four moves.
That doesn't work on a psychic steel type.
I mean, it works. It's just not very effective.
Yeah.
Why is Jirachi part steel?
I don't know.
Why isn't he a fairy at this point?
You think he would be, but apparently not. Though at the same time, it's the same way as why is the... Well, at first, before you realize why the... Pokemon that's meant to represent the sun is weak to fire types.
I mean...
And is not a fire type.
I mean, I know. Should I explain it?
Go ahead. We've got time to kill.
So, why Solgaleo is not fire type and represents the sun? Surprise, sun movement is based off of alchemy. Alchemists believe the sun was a hot, molten ball of iron.
Yep.
So, and I don't know why psychic... I mean, Lunala's part psychic too. But that's why Solgaleo's...
Probably just to keep the theme.
That's why Solgaleo's steel. Because it's thought the sun is just a big molten ball of iron.
Yep. Oh, poor Jirachi.
You gotta nurse it back to health. I will protect this. Jirachi's a cinnamon roll.
At least it's more manageable than Manaphy.
Yeah. And he doesn't need a bunch of purple gummies or whatever.
Yep.
Now, on Jirachi being part steel type, because of his typing and Iron Head and Serene Grace, he was a monster in Gen 5 competitive.
Yep.
Oh, come on now. You don't do that at Oricorio.
That's just cruel.
That's his sister. I I don't know.
Is no one going to acknowledge the Absol?
He's trying to break out. And they thought Absol was bad. Aw.
Yeah. Yeah, it took me long enough. Psycho cut!
Wasn't that, Razor Wind, which takes two moves to charge?
Probably was. But remember, this is the anime, where you could win a gym battle by activating the sprinklers in a rock gym.
True. Very true.
And then win your second gym badge because the gym leader's older sisters said you were never going to win if he used the Pikachu anyway.
I saw a gym battle. Tate and Lisa from third gen. Like, what was it? Master Quest or something else?
Advanced Generation was the Gen 3 series.
Yeah, Tate and Liza.
Oh, yeah.
That... He did a... Pikachu did a thunder... Double battle. Pikachu did a thunder onto Swellow that he was riding, and they turned gold? I don't understand.
Logic!
I don't get it either. I mean, if you think anime logic is bad, if Flygon uses Dig and you use Earthquake on Flygon, Flygon will avoid it with Levitate.
How do you do that?
I don't know. I saw this one thing with Mimikyu that, Psyduck uses Soak on Mimikyu, so he's not immune to Dragon anymore. Latios uses Dragon, Draco Meteor, and Mimikyu's Disguise is just... Mimikyu takes no damage because of Disguise.
I am going to hit you with the strongest move in the game, and you shake it off!
Mimikyu.
Logic.
I love Mimikyu.
I'm definitely getting a Mimikyu when it comes out.
Gee, you think?
It's not like we didn't see that before.
You never see Maxie in this movie, surprisingly enough.
Nope.
Best friend, nothing else.
Yes, friend.
How far away is Farina? Yeah. Oh, probably almost a week away.
Yeah, probably.
Because the Millennium Comet is a week.
Yep.
Time to whip out the big guns.
No, because you're evil. So now I shall use my portal car.
All the enemies have this, like, some kind of thing that they sit and fly around. Like, Robotnik's...
Yeah, you get that as a graduation present from villain school.
Robotnik had that.
You get the flying car, you get a small squadron of mooks, and you get hit the writing for your first evil plan.
Ooh. I want to go to villain school.
I've heard it's not a very good school. The employment rates leaving the school isn't very good, and the fees for it are criminal.
Ha! That's too good.
I couldn't resist.
I didn't realize how much sleeping was in this movie.
Jirachi and the Sleep Makers.
I'm tired.
Behold, bonding of the two female characters in this entire movie.
And one female character you'll never see again.
Yep.
Backstory time.
This is when we inject sympathy into the clearly villain character.
Yeah. This is more sympathy into Oricorio. We're not calling her Diane.
No, it's always Oricorio now.
Why Butterfree?
Is one of them from Kanto?
Oh, that's how he gets his name. But wait, what'd you ask?
I think it was always called Butler, so...
No, she just called him Butler. I have no idea what his real name is. It's probably something
Who
stupid.
knows?
What's the stupidest name you could give to a person?
Well, going to the Pokemon Adventures manga, they always call their characters but named after the games.
Yeah, but
So in Generation 5, when you've got the Black 2 and White 2 arc, where the male character is Lack 2 and the female character is Y2.
are you kidding me?
No, I'm being deadly serious. Oh yeah, Heroes of Hoenn.
Is that what this music is?
Yep, that's the name of the song.
Was this played during the anime?
Yep.
I thought there was like a I thought I heard there was a
Behold,
reason.
Rocket Ramen Noodles.
I thought there was a reason that they put this in, but I forgot. It's still a good song though.
Yeah.
Jirachi is helping.
Jirachi, don't you have confusion or teleport or something?
Teleport would work.
Yeah. Jirachi, I wish to be teleported to where you were born. Along with the rest of
That's a
us.
good question. How come he just doesn't do that? Does he forgot where he was?
Yeah.
Well, maybe. Well, if you're like in a place that you don't know of, I guess it's kind of hard to teleport. But
True, but
Jirachi,
he always wakes up every 1,000
they were
years,
stuck
so.
in dirt. Jirachi literally could have teleported the van out of it. They didn't have to push it.
Yep. And now, snowy mountains? We really are going to Mount Freeze!
There's Mount Freeze right there. Where's Articuno?
Yeah. No, he lives. Articuno lives in Frosty Forest. Articuno is where Ninetales lives.
Oh, true.
Though, speaking of which, Chunsoft, Game Freak, has a bit of a hint, hint, nudge, nudge. Maybe Red Blue Rescue Team remakes on the Switch using the Super Mystery Dungeon engine and Alolan Ninetales to replace the Ninetales in the Mount Freeze?
Ooh,
Hint,
Nantes.
hint, nudge, nudge.
Maybe only new games. Now, this is a scene I want to point out. Ash mentions that he misses someone before, mentioning Misty. But this was only in the dub, not the sub.
Yep. What was it in the sub?
I forgot. I know that this is dub only though, so
Yep.
I'm not sure if this is even canon or not.
None of the movies are canon.
Poke shippers had too much faith. Friends and nothing more.
Friends.
The friend zone. I saw this hilarious gif of when the last part with Serena going down the escalator, and then she thinks of the friend zone where all the other girls, and Latias, and for some reason Bayleaf was there too.
Oh yeah, Bailey.
Yeah, the one that basically humped Ash's leg for the whole series.
Yep.
Bayleaf got friend zoned by Ash.
Behold, where we are going to hold the climax of the movie.
This place reminds me of Agate Village from of Coliseum.
If only I had a GameCube.
Oh, you never played Coliseum?
Tropius.
Tropius looks awesome in this movie.
Yeah.
And ma. Hey,
Vibrava!
bro.
Mezzeleaf!
Nuzlocke.
Oh, yeah.
I would totally visit this place if this was real.
Me too. Ooh, one more day. And I swear the pattern looks a lot like a Dragonair.
I think it's actually what the Millennium Comet's supposed to look like.
Yeah.
Me. I don't have a sleeping problem.
Don't know what you're talking about. Oh, they do acknowledge that the time's running out. Unlike they do for Temple of the Sea.
Oh. Max knew that that time was running out when it was like 5 days.
Yeah, true. But still, May never did until the last moment.
I love this, like, passive aggressiveness. She knows that he wants to stay up. He's like, nah, I know a song that will put you to sleep.
Behold, I will use the poke flute.
I can't tell if Brock is nodding off or is he still awake. It's hard to tell with his eyes closed all the time.
Yeah. Oh, what was really weird with the anime, when they go to the Battle Frontier?
Uh-huh.
Pike Queen Lucy has a thing for Pokemon with Brock eyes.
No, she had a thing for Brock, didn't she? Wait, what was it?
True, because all of her Pokemon in her own house, not for the Battle Pike, all had Brock eyes.
Wait, which Pokemon?
Like, Snorlax, I'll look up quickly what it is.
Alright.
I know for certain she had a Snorlax.
What other Pokemon that we knew had closed eyes? Oh, that's just so cute.
Bloom.
Bloom never gets acknowledged.
Firefox update.
Tropius's cry. Hi, Flygon. Tropius's cry is just him
slurping. Hi, I came to receive my Megastone.
Sorry. No more Megas.
Oh.
This is Flygon.
But I was next in line.
This is Flygon looking over the Mega Evolution line.
I'm noticing a distinct lack of Flygonite.
Yeah, too bad. Oh, here, Flygon, have a Z-move. That all dragon ground types can learn.
You're dead to me, creators.
Here, you see this...
And then he just flies over to stand next to my Milotic.
Not even an Alola form. And I think Alola forms are only exclusive to first-gen Pokemon.
Yeah. Okay, at home, Pike Queen Lucy has an Abra, a Snorlax, a Cyndaquil, a Swinub, a Makuhita, and a Skitty.
That makes sense. I'm gonna have to remember that later. Too bad.
Too bad! The movie's wrapping up, son! Sorry, Genie rules, I can't do that.
But the movie time is running out, and this is my only time to shine. Max, let me go.
I must do it. The plot calls to me.
I'm going to say hi to Porygon for you. For all the Pokemon that's banned from TV. Yep. Well, I wouldn't say Jirachi's banned, but they're never going to use him again.
No, because legendary.
See you in 20 years.
Yep.
What month was Jirachi? February.
Pun?
March. I think Jirachi was April during the whole distribution thing.
Yeah, it was April because it started in February with Mew. Behold, I got here first, so I know how to set up traps.
Mine. Oh, God. It's been a trap all along. And Jirachi...
And yet did no one see his flying ship?
Well, he blocked the view from it.
Not when they were outside.
How is Jirachi still asleep through this? Magic.
Look, a plot distraction!
Where?
Flee!
Oh my god.
Look, I'm evil. See, shadow eyes. Look, see, trap. Look, dark shadings. I'm the bad guy.
Careful with that Jirachi, man.
Boop. Look at how flamboyant I am. I am the bad guy.
How long did it take for him to set this up?
I don't know. We never see.
That...
Behold, the machine my grandfather gave me after he was done with it in The Power of One.
I could see them being related.
Yeah, that's all I think of when I see that machine. It's just, it reminds me so much of the one from the second movie.
I'm thinking if we do a movie com.
Oh yeah, we're in this movie.
I think I'm gonna watch 2000 soon. You know, first movie was actually in theaters not too long ago.
Lucky, we never get that.
The only re-release I ever watched was probably the Lion King 3D one.
Hmm.
That was so good. I mean, if I want...
At least on the plus side, while you get things like movies going back to cinemas, is I get Sun and Moon before you do because of time zones.
Lucky. Don't tell me anything about...
Don't worry, I'll save spoilers because it's... I'll save spoilers until after you get it. I'm not cruel.
Okay, here's a spoiler. What starter are you picking?
I don't know, because I was originally going to stick with Rallet, and then we got Brionne in Publius' fully evolved form.
Yeah, I mean, I've lit just... the unpopular one.
So you can feed it cat treats?
Okay, where did Absol come from? Was he just standing in the corner?
I'm wherever the plot needs me to be, for I am Absol.
Alright, so Salamence is my favorite Pokemon, and they make Salamence with the bad guy?
Yep. For I am Flygon.
Lego. I still don't get a Megastone.
Will this give me a Megastone?
No.
No, but this will give you a time in a movie.
Yay.
Close enough.
Now, Flygon, you had a choice between a Megastone and movie time. What did you pick?
Movie time.
That's a really nice picture of a... That is like the Primal Groudon painting in Granite Cave in Oros.
It all comes together. Behold, I got a Megastone and I get time in a movie. Aha, I win.
Also my favorite Pokemon.
I also get time in the next region of the anime.
This is a proper size for a Salamence. I think that's closest to Pokedex size, if not maybe a little bigger.
I think so. Though to be fair, the Pokedex is very lenient on numbers.
I mean, did you see how big Furret is? Furret's as big as a... He's like 5'11".
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Yeah, Wailord as well. Biggest Pokemon in the ocean, weighs next to nothing. Where?
Float whale Pokemon. Also, why?
Logic.
There you go. You got it.
Well, this is not going to have any side effects at all.
Bye.
No, you stole my plot, MacGuffin!
Too late. He is hatching.
Behold, I too can create a type null-like Pokemon!
What's that? I couldn't hear you, I was dreaming. Okay, how does he know that's a true eye?
Because plot.
Okay. Yeah, that's me.
Do you have purple gummies with me?
I don't know.
Oh, wait, no. Purple gummies, I think, is actually poison type. I think the gummy for psychic types is the gold gummy.
Oh, yeah, you're right. That's kind of weird, actually. Bye.
Well, it's the same as why Sabrina's badge in Generation 3 was a gold badge.
But the thing is, the marsh badge and the soul badge were actually mixed up.
Yep.
So, there we go. I'm okay, but I was just worried about Jirachi more than you.
Yep. And, May, are you sure this is not going to continue in another movie in the not-too-distant future? I don't know what you're talking about. Like with another small or legendary Pokemon, maybe a blue water type. Nope, don't know what you're talking about.
Max got Jirachi and May got Manaphy.
Yep. I think Max got the better deal, honestly.
Yeah. Yeah, he did.
Behold, I stand before you.
Now, this is what... I'm not sure if this movie calls it that or something else calls it that, but this is what I like to call fake Groudon.
Yeah, it basically is.
That's not Groudon. If you were to give this...
That's...
If you were to give this Groudon...
It's not the right one.
What?
It's not the right one. Oh no, I fell for the villain trick of I got too overconfident. No!
Imagine this music playing, and then you see Groudon's face, and it's just Ditto. Ditto. Or,
oh, I'd love that.
Either that or even better Mimikyu.
What's that? It's a Zoroark.
Oh my god. Well, at least Zoroark has good imitations, not Ditto.
True.
Now, if you were to give this Pokemon a typing, what would you give him?
Well, clearly fire type, because all the trees are dying.
Well, I would actually give him a poison type.
Thank you, Brock. I just told the audience that.
I would give him a poison type, if anything.
Yeah, true. Fire poison?
Or ground poison, really. Because Groudon's ground type.
That works.
Who touched me?
Who did that?
And for some reason, water?
Behold, I can use water types.
Or is that goo?
I am better than Volcanion in every way. For I get four types.
He's not even a Pokemon. I must say, I love the concept and design of fake Groudon.
Yep.
Num. Well, Groudon...
Oh no, not the Litten and Poochyena. Not the Swablu!
What fake Groudon essentially does is...
We need to find Megastones! We need to find Megastones!
What fake Groudon essentially does is try to destroy the world. This is the opposite of what Zygarde does.
Yep. So why isn't Zygarde waking up?
Zygarde didn't exist yet.
Oh no, another reason could be is that Zygarde only lives in Kalos, and as soon as it heard about what was happening, it tried to get here, but by the time it got here, the movie had finished.
Like all you see is Squishy, like, right after this movie. It's like, no.
Oh, shoot.
abort mission. Nom. Mine.
You're all mine now.
He just digests them.
Oh, well, definitely water type.
No, not the Tropius. Yeah, I know this.
Not the Tropius.
Or they can just stay there.
Oh, no, they can stay there. Not the Breloom. Oh, Nuzlocke.
No, my Nuzlocke. I failed it.
I didn't know I was the villain!
Oh, like you?
Yeah. No, Oricorio.
Bye. When I first saw this, I thought they were, like, dating, and now that I see it, it's like, oh, she's his sister. Well.
Yep. Well, sister in the English dub, where it could be worse. It could be like with Sailor Moon, where they're cousins.
Yeah, totally cousins. What are you talking about?
They're totally not lesbians.
No, cousins. I was actually just thinking that, too.
Gotta love localization, things like that.
And even then, it's still kind of horrible if you think about it.
Yeah.
Bye.
Oh, yeah, sure. Now you use teleport.
If I ever had teleport, every time I used teleport, I would just be like, bye.
Later.
Teleportation is a cool ability.
This is what I get for going to the same school as Perfect Chaos.
Jirachi, oh right, I could do that. And I've been like watching DBZ Abridged lately, so.
I haven't seen it just because I don't watch DBZ.
You don't have to watch DBZ to watch Abridged.
True.
You know what's funny? I was actually talking to my brother about DBZ. He's like, yeah, I've been roped into watching Abridged. And he's like, good, watch Abridged to understand what's happening in DBZ. And he recommends Super to me. So that could be a possibility.
Oh yeah, I actually just remembered something.
Yeah?
Learned of a movie that got greenlit yesterday.
What movie?
We're getting a Furby movie.
Really? I'm not surprised. Troll movie is happening.
We're getting an emoji movie.
What is with these movies? I hate them.
I know. Here's something that makes the Furby movie even funnier. When I was in grade 5, so around 10 to 11 years old,
yeah.
We were doing a term project where we had to make these short films.
Yeah.
One of the films my group wanted to do was a movie about killer Furbies.
Did you make that movie?
So now that No, we never got it. We never developed it far enough to get it greenlit.
Okay.
So what makes it... Now that I hear about this Furby movie, I kind of want it to be a horror movie.
No, I think it's going to be like the same movie like Smurfs and Trolls and... whatever. Emoji. Lego.
Why? The Lego movie at least was good.
Yeah. But it's like the same thing. It's like, hey, let's get this thing that everyone knows and make a movie out of it. And what the troll movie, at least what I saw from the trailers, did wrong, is like, they use Sound of Silence, which is popular right now, because memes, and one of the trolls screams YOLO, and I'm like, I just can't stand it.
Yep.
And Jirachi just said, Butler isn't bad, so...
Yep. Oh yeah, we're in this movie.
Bye.
Am I here too?
It's bubbly in here.
Yeah.
And what about the other Pokemon?
Oh yeah, those
and
two.
And Team Rocket.
Do we have to?
They're kind of our backup plan for when we don't have any conflict during an episode, so yeah.
Oh. But I don't want them to keep trying to chase me. They've been doing it for 3 regions at this point, and I can know they're only going to keep going.
I don't know why
for another 3 at least.
I don't know why Giovanni put so much faith in them.
I don't think he does. I think it's a case of... Now, if he's doing paperwork, they get a call going, oh, sir, we want to go to this region. Go wherever you want. Go there.
No, Giovanni always says, yeah, go to this region. So I have no idea why he puts so much faith in them.
Yeah, and what you don't see is as soon as the scene changes, he goes to his secretary and goes, why do we keep them around? The secretary just goes, because we have a quota for people we can recruit, and we can't recruit any new people at the moment, so
I'm surprised
they've all we got.
I'm surprised Giovanni doesn't have like 20 Pikachu already. Why do they need Ash's Pikachu is beyond me.
Who knows?
Why didn't they go after Greninja?
I think at this point it's just Stockholm Syndrome.
Not true. Bye.
Well, we're screwed.
Got it.
Oh. Ash, when did you become a seeker?
We're good. So we need to...
Are you sure you're not... Are you sure this won't just finish him?
Is this not a trick?
Behold, this is actually a trick room.
Trick room didn't exist till Gen 4. Or 5.
No, I think it was around Gen 4. Yeah. And besides, this is the only movie where they have only Generation 3 Pokemon. Yeah. From Destiny Deoxys onwards, they kept throwing in Generation 4 Pokemon. So, for the sake of this, Trick Room exists.
Okay.
It may as well.
Bye.
So long.
Would you want this Groudon to be your pet?
It's so cute.
I have come...
I'll feed him, and I'll hug him, and I'll call him Biffalo the Second. So that's why you ate the that's why you ate the Tropius, because of the bananas.
Exactly. All he wants is just fruit. I want your mangoes. I want that big yellow mango or lemon on you.
That's not a mango.
You sure? What have I been eating?
Yeah. The weird thing about this as well, classic anime trope, liver becomes really hard to use when in the situation is very tense, but as soon as it's not needed, it becomes very easy to move.
Maybe Ash isn't strong enough, I don't know.
Behold, for I am a god.
Okay, this is never named or mentioned in this, and it actually looks really funny. Jirachi is charging up Doom Desire. Is that an elephant? Was that an elephant that he just roared? Did you hear that?
Was this by the same team who's doing the Pokemon Generation shorts?
Who is an elephant?
Speaking of, we saw the Torn World!
I know.
We saw the Torn World in Generations.
I know you're excited by that. Aw,
that should probably give you an
hug.
Idea of when this was recorded.
Yeah. Aw, he just wants a hug, though.
Huggles.
It's just gross. Okay, this
is
the best.
It's all sticky and gooey, and it gets everywhere.
This is the best. Look at fake Groudon's face.
Oh, shoot.
It's time for Doom Desire. Yay! Oh, my God. Oh, that's the best.
I thought you said no nut shots.
Okay, that fake Groudon is dead.
Yeah, so is everyone inside of it, because I think only Jirachi can breathe in space.
Why is this Doom Desire?
Jirachi, you just killed everyone in there.
No, they're fine.
Oh. That's nowhere near as funny.
He's just teleporting them back. Hi.
See ya. Where am I?
What happened? What happened while I was gone? Did we do it? Did we kill the thing?
Did the thing happen? Oricorio, you live!
Yes, and that's why Oricorio's in Sun Moon.
But look, could we travel back to the Alola region? I want to breed birds for a bit.
Alright.
Anyone want to explain what just happened?
Behold, Jirachi.
For I am a ghost now.
I have to go. My planet needs me.
This is your planet.
I don't think he's from Earth.
He was never confirmed to be an alien.
I mean, he's from space, right?
No, I don't think so.
But he's from the stars.
Yeah, but he's not like Clefairy, Deoxys, or the EGM and Behem.
Yeah.
They're confirmed as aliens. Jirachi isn't.
I always thought he was from the stars.
I don't think so.
But I mean, he looks like a star. His whole design is based off the Japanese holiday of Tanabata, which is wishing on stars.
Except for one small problem. This is for kids. We can't have Japanese culture in these.
Enjoy your hamburger, Apollo.
Enjoy your jelly-filled donuts.
No, do you remember that comic?
Yeah, I do.
That was so good.
Eat your hamburgers, Apollo.
There was like a bunch of variations of that comic. I gotta send them to you.
Localization errors at their finest.
Yeah. Oh, don't go like this.
You can stop singing now, guys.
No, that's his wish, though.
But he's a comet now.
More of a cocoon. Bye! Goody.
So long, thanks for all the fish.
I'm totally listening to the song after. I mean, it is in the credits, so.
Yeah. I thought the land pulsating like this was a bad thing.
I don't know why this is happening.
Because Jirachi.
I mean, Max, you're in all of our hearts.
It's magic!
I mean, you're in all of our hearts too, Max, because you're never going to be appear in the anime ever again. We all know this.
No, he's not mine. Max can stay in Hoenn.
What's he doing now? And here they are closing the movie. Or at least closing the scene. They never actually close the movie, do they?
They close Spell the Unknown.
Yeah, they closed 2000. Did they close the first movie?
I'm not sure.
No. The Sight of Mew closed the movie.
Yeah. Oh, so this is Alola! This is where you're going to raise your Oricorio.
Yeah. Well, Hoenn is actually not too far away from Alola. Oh, I know what Mei's wish was. She wanted to be in the anime again. And she got her wish in 4th gen.
Yep. Yeah, but at the same time, Ash, you've gone 6 generations and still not won the league.
He got 2nd place. That's pretty close.
True. And you'd think that by now he'll just go, you know what, stop trying to do this the hard way. I just want to win this thing, damn it.
Well, that was actually the movie.
Yep.
Here's that song I've been talking about. So, what do you think?
The one you've totally not been building up this entire time.
Yeah. What do you think of Jirachi Wishmaker, though?
It was alright. A lot of really stupid moments.
Although, a lot of funny ones, too.
Yeah.
If you would rate this movie out of whatever out of 10?
Say about a 7.
Yeah. 7.
6.5 to 7.
7.5 out of 10. Stone Hoenn, too much water.
Yeah,
7.10 would go to Manaphy. Too much water.
Yeah.
Whale, the sight of Wailord gives it negative points. Now, I would give it a, 6.5 would sound about right. Oh, there's a sun and moon on his thing! Sun and moon! Confirmed!
At least it's a little bit more subtle than what they did in the actual anime, where you had the Solrock and Lunatone baubles.
Right in front of the camera.
Yeah. Why does this sound like it should belong in a Disney movie?
Because it's that good.
True.
You know what's cool about this scene in the credits? They were looking at constellations, and these constellations... These assets of these constellations are in Pokemon Channel.
Yeah.
Have you ever played that game? Oh, no, wait, you didn't have a GameCube.
Low blow, Marissa. Low blow.
I'm sorry. Anyway, Little Dipper becomes Teddy Ursa, Ursa Minor, and then you get Ursa Major. Can you guess what that is?
Ursa Ren.
So in Pokemon Channel, at the ending, where you get all the Pichu Brothers episodes and make up a full episode, a full cartoon of the Pichu Brothers, you could actually view it in the nighttime sky, unlocked by Jirachi, of all things.
It all comes together.
And these are actually real constellations, too.
Oh, Milotic.
Yeah, I know. This is the Snake Bearer, otherwise known as the Hidden...
At the start of it, it looked like a Phantom. Yeah. But Phantom didn't exist yet.
Hidden 13th Zodiac.
Machoke holding a Survivor.
Yeah, I know. And look what it is! We're back in the third movie! Or is this the fourth movie? I can't tell.
Not sure. That castle looks like it's the one from Lucario and the Mystery of Mew.
Yeah, I think that's where it's from. Even though it doesn't exist yet.
Yeah.
There's one constellation I always see in the night sky. It's not this one, and this one's just Gligar. It's sad that I remember these.
Not really.
Well, me, I do look up what these constellations. This is the one one I see in my sky is Cygnus, the swan, but actuality it's just a Kyogre.
Yeah, because Swanna didn't exist yet.
True. Kyogre is much cooler anyway.
Yeah.
I think this is the only time in a American thing you actually hear the Japanese singer. And this is the only time.
Yeah,
this is the only time.
I think so as well.
Sorry. This is the only time where you see the other Pokemon, like Beautifly and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, in the beginning you saw Corphish and all that, but they never were in this.
Yep. Pichu, Torchic, Pokeball,
Pikachu,
Torchic,
Lotad, Mudkip, Psyduck,
Beautifly.
Off-screen ones. Wait, are they in the fifth movie now? Heroes, I mean?
I don't think so.
Alright. Oh, I forgot this one. It's Gardevoir.
Who's that
Gardevoir.
Pokemon?
It has to be Gardevoir, right? Virgo, I got it. We're close.
Yep.
No, it's not Virgo. It's like close to Virgo, I think. Oh, it's one star. What else could it be? Hi, Pikachu.
They're not even trying with that
it's
one.
It's just one star. The North Star is just Pikachu.
At least the animation is actually really good for the time.
Yeah.
So
that was Jirachi Wishmaker.
Yeah, and the next one we're doing, we're skipping Destiny Deoxys, because the next movie is my personal favorite of the Pokemon movies, even though apparently it's now deemed a meme to like it, Lucario and the Mystery of Mew.
It's going to be exciting. We should do Destiny Deoxys down the road, because that is a good movie.
Yeah.
We're not hating on Destiny Deoxys by skipping it. Not at all.
No, it's just we can only do four of these movies.
Yeah. So.
We've also got no plans of doing the Generation 4 movies yet, but that's because the way the Generation 4 movies were designed, you've got to do them one after the other. They're a constant story. So, if we do Rise of Darkrai, that means the next two movies are going to be Giratina and the Sky Warrior, and then Arceus and the Jewel of Life.
Right. I never noticed that with those movies, actually.
You didn't?
No, I didn't know they were like a continuous story.
Yeah, no, they were. They even make a note, they even pointed out in Arceus and the Jewel of Life.
Alright. I have to see that. Anyway, that was our movie con, but not the end of the festival for Sun Moon's launch.
Nope, because tomorrow, at least for when this will be going live, tomorrow is the review that probably a lot of original fans have been wanting us to do, but you can thank their initial release dates for this. I think, Marissa, tomorrow, let's head to the Johto region for a little bit.
Yeah, I forgot some stuff there.
Yeah, you kind of have to do this whole gold, silver, crystal thing. I don't know what that's about. Do you?
Crystal? I haven't heard of Chris's name in such a long time.
I thought her name was Lyra.
Lyra sounds a bit more familiar, but who's Chris?
I don't know. We'll find out eventually.
Alright. Tune in next time where we visit Johto for our Gen 2... What do you call it?
Review. It's the review itself.
Yeah, review of Gen 2. Wait, Counting remakes or not counting remakes? I forgot how we
counting did remi- Counting right. remakes.
Alright, Johto reviews tomorrow.
And how fitting that the Johto review comes out the day that Gold, Silver, and Crystal was originally released in Japan, and the day before the launch of Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon.
So exciting.
In terms of midnight launch.
Yeah. Still so exciting. I have my Litten plush on my desk, and it gets me hyped for it.
Sun and Moon hype!
I know! We'll see you later.
Later, guys.